And welcome back to some more Undertale. Now, for those who don't know, we're facing Undyne here, and I died last time. I died a couple times. what I have determined I will try this time, watching back my videos, or my last video, Undyne mentioned that when we were green, we couldn't escape. So when we're not green, I'm gonna try to flee, because it's the only thing I haven't done is attempt to flee. Just gonna go through that. On guard. Happens. As long as you're green, you can't escape. I'm gonna do my best not to kill Undyne this time. Although technically I didn't. I almost did, or something. She managed to come back from the dead, or something. Undyne suplexes a huge boulder just because she can. I don't remember that one. Menacing smile. Bullets get faster. Great, that's really what I wanted to do. Yeah, now I suck. Damn it. Now we're red, so we can flee. Escape. Oh, she's coming. You won't get away from me this time. Honestly, I'm doing you a favor. No human has ever made it past Asgore. The bicycle. Oop. All right, we can flee again. Oh! What does it say? Welcome or something. You escaped from me for the last time. So, yeah, I guess we can escape a few more times and see how that goes. If we get far enough away, maybe we can get to safety. Alphys told me humans were determined. I see now what she meant by that. I hate those things. Cool, we're almost full. I like to see it when I didn't waste any points. Are those claws natural? Those things you gotta go at the last second or something. See, I'm really not that good at this, guys. You've probably noticed. Yourself. I love you. Oh, this one does not love me very much. Hold on, I got an itch. Okay, good. Okay. I read again. Flip your spear around. It says, "Welcome to Hotland. Someone's calling."
Hey, what's up? I was just thinking, you, me, and Undyne should all hang out sometime. I think you would make great pals.
Yeah, right.
Let's meet up at her house later.
Click.
Stop running away.
Damn it. Oh wait, could I have escaped? Damn it. Damn it.
Come back here, you little punk!
I thought Sans might help me. Should I try talking to Sans? No, I just gotta run across that branch. Wait. Am I red? I can flee. Can't move.
Armor. So hot.
But I can't give up. Oh wow, okay. What's this stuff? Banana peels? It's a water cooler. Take a cup of water. I take a cup of water. Oh, to give to her? Okay. We don't even have water. I guess I sort of have it. I'm holding the water. Get rid of the water. Can I get more? Let's see what happens, because I like to see. She looks dry. Yeah, that's what I was trying to see. Alright. Blocking my way anyway, so. Give Undyne the water? Yes. This is like Darth Vader under the mask. Doesn't say a word. Can I get more water? Got more water for you. The cup of water returned to the water cooler? How the hell would that happen? Oh. Sans is gone. Alright, I'm really not gonna go all the way back. Should I? I'm stupid. Just want to see what happens. Undyne. Oh, I can save. That's right. The howling wind is now a breeze. This gives you determination. Everything gives me friggin' determination, man. Alright, she's just completely gone. Cool. I can now, like, proceed with the game. Advance and stuff. It's always good news. So yeah, my idea was a good one. What the hell are you? You were not there before. Okay. I was thirsty, so I came over from Waterfall to get a drink. Give him a drink. Are you just carrying that around to look sophisticated? Because it's not working. Just wanted to give it to you. The water evaporated from the heat. The cup evaporated too. Hello? Seeing such a strange laboratory in a place like this, you're filled with determination. This is a laboratory? Hi? Sorry, Undyne, like, told us there was totally a human in the area. So, like, us royal guards are blocking off the elevators for now. Yeah, even if the elevators aren't working anyway, we'll do our best, Ms. Undyne. A little wavering. This one doesn't speak. It says what? Okay, we got stairs and we got this way. There's a lab there. Okay. What's down this way then? Oh my god. It's the Grim Reaper and the River Styx. Let me go in the lab. Who the hell could that be? It's you! Yep. It's too dark to see near the walls. Doesn't look that dark. Definitely been in darker places, that's for sure. Okay, so I can see this stuff, but I can't see this stuff. Okay, let's go this way. Oh. Ah, lights. Oh, my god. I didn't expect you to show up so soon. I haven't showered. I'm barely dressed. It's all messy and... And? Hiya! I'm Dr. Alphys. I'm Asgore's royal scientist. But, I'm not one of the bad guys. Actually, since you stepped out of the ruins, I've, been observing your journey through my console. Your fights, your friendships, everything. I was originally going to stop you, but watching someone on the screen really makes you root for them. So, now I want to help you. Using my knowledge, I can easily guide you through Heartland. I know a way right to Asgore's castle, no problem. Well, actually, there's just a tiny issue. A long time ago, I made a robot named Metaton. Originally, I built him to be an entertainment robot. You know, like a robotic TV star or something. Anyway, recently I decided to make him more useful. You know, just some small practical adjustments. Like, anti-human combat features? Of course, when I saw you coming, I immediately decided I have to remove these features. Unfortunately, I may have made a teensy mistake while doing so. And, now he's an unstoppable killing machine with a thirst for human blood. But, hopefully we won't run into him. Okay. Did you hear something? Yes. It's coming. How big is this thing? Oh no.
Oh yes. Welcome, beauties. To today's quiz show.
What?
Oh boy, I can already tell it's going to be a great show. Everyone give a big hand for our wonderful contestant.
Okay.
Never played before, gorgeous. No problem, it's simple. There's only one rule. Answer correctly, or you die.
Okay. Metaton attacks. Check or cry? Oh my god. Attack 30, defense 255, like the ASCII character set. I get it. His metal body renders him invulnerable to attack. Well, then we won't attack him.
Let's start with an easy one. What's the prize for answering correctly?
More questions.
Right, sounds like you get it. The quiz show continues.
Cry? Screaming is against the rules.
Here's your terrific prize. What's the king's full name?
Asgore Dreamer.
Correct. What a terrific answer. Enough about you, let's talk about me. What are robots made of?
Hopes and dreams. Metal and magic.
Too easy for you, huh? Here's another easy one for you.
I'm not reading all that. I have no frickin' idea. A hasn't been an answer yet.
Wrong, wrong, wrong. Don't count on your victory. How many flies are in this jar?
No freaking idea.
Completely, utterly wrong.
I gotta take a crab apple.
Let's play memory game.
Oh god.
What monster is this?
Froggit.
Boy, that's embarrassing, huh?
That wasn't Froggit?
But can you get this one? Would you smooch a ghost? Great answer, I love it.
Yep, yeah.
Here's a simple one. How many letters in the name meant a
ton? No. I don't know. Quiz show continues.
Time to break out the bang guns.
In a dating simulation video game, what is Mew Mew's favorite food? Snail ice cream in the fourth chapter. Snail flavor, and she's the only one who wants. It's one of my favorite parts of the game. It's actually very valuable. Friendship and...
Elvis. You aren't helping our contestant, are you? Oh, you should have told me. I'll ask a question. You'll be sure to know the answer to.
Dr. Alphys have a crush on. I have no idea.
Correct.
It's correct that I don't know.
Dr. Alphys has a crush on the unknowable. You see, Alphys believes there is someone out there. Someone watching her. Someone she thinks is cute and interesting.
Well, Alphys is a female, okay?
Hello, theoretical person. Dr. Alphys likes you. Too bad you are not real.
Derisive laugh track.
Hey, I've done research about this.
There are alternate universes out there. Someday, maybe, I could meet them.
You said the exact thing, same thing about Mew Mew Kissy Cutie. But I'll give you the benefit of the doubt. Person, if you are out there, how about giving us a sign right now? That settles that, doesn't it? Well. With Dr. Alphys helping you, the show has no dramatic tension. We can't go on like this, but... but... this was just a pilot episode. Next up, more drama. More romance. More bloodshed. Until next time, darlings.
Well, that was certainly something. I'm glad I'm still alive.
Wait. Let me give you my phone number.
Hold on a second, guys. Need a drink.
But then, maybe, if you need help, I could... What? Where'd you get that phone? It's ancient. It doesn't even have texting. Wait a second, please.
You made me a better phone?
Here, I upgraded it for you. It can do texting, items. It's got a keychain. I even signed you up for the Underground's number one social network.
Now we're officially friends. I'm going to the bathroom. Well, now we can look at stuff. It's a video feed of your location. I need to buy healing items and stuff. Or at least get to a box with my healing items. A garbage can, but it's pretty cute. Seems like the notes to something, but it's all written in chicken scratch. It seems like a walkthrough to a game, or... It's a computer. It's accessing some kind of puzzle in Snowden. It's a teacup shaped like a yellow lizard. It's full of... soda? It's a beat-up figurine of a female human with cat ears. The fridge is filled with instant noodles and soda. Take a package of noodles? Sure. You got the instant noodles. Heals HP, well, we don't know how much. Comes with everything you need for a quick meal. Can I get more? Nope. It's a half-empty bag of dog food. That's a pretty big-ass thing of dog food. It's a bathroom sign. Yellow feet are tapping just behind the door. There's a hole and there's a conveyor belt. Oh. Let's go in the hole. I can't. The space behind the wall is only a few feet wide. Okay. Whee! Cool. Scientific books. They seem very dusty. All these books are labeled human history. Read one. You look inside a book. It's a comic of a giant robot fighting a beautiful alien princess. This doesn't strike you as very accurate. Let's see if there's another one. Nope. What is that machine over there? VHSs and DVDs of various cartoons. They are all labeled human history. Oh, that's a friendly little teapot type thing with plants growing out of it. All these books are labeled human history. It's a comic book. Two scantily clad chefs are flinging energy pancakes at each other. This doesn't strike you as very accurate. Propaganda, I tell you, it's all propaganda. A hideous android is running to school with toast in its mouth. Seems like it's late. Pink goop drips from this strange machine. Same. A chainsaw? Looks like Alphys's work table. Seems dusty. The wardrobe is full of dirty lab coats and a single clean dress. There are letters from many monsters here. Froggit, Snowy, Doggo. They're all unopened. It's a lamp with pink fish on a lampshade. There's no light bulb. Okay, look at the picture. An incredible invention. When not in use, this bed folds into an extremely easy to draw box. Okay, look at it. It's a promo poster for Metaton's TV premiere. On the flap it says, "Thank you for making my dreams come true." Thank you. Oh. It's out of the bathroom. Well, I can't do anything there. Well, let's call her then. Oh. Well, I really have, like, nothing. I have dimensional boxes? Oh! I can get my stuff right out of there. I thought I had to get to a box. I didn't see that last time. And I have two boxes I can... Cool. Now I need to buy crap loads of stuff. Oh, that's right. That was part of the cell she gave me. Awesome. The universe is ripe with possibilities. Now I just have to, like, find more stuff, buy more stuff. I would buy a crap load of stuff, I'm telling you. Anyway. Let's call her. Oh, I can't call her. Just for the hell of it?
A lab? My brother would love that. He loves science fiction. Especially when it's real. Wait, that bag of dog food looks familiar. I remember seeing it in Sansa's room. Yeah, I asked him why he had it. He told me he was trying to eat healthier.
Excuse me. Alright, so... So, determination. Alright, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. Guess I'm gonna see what's past the laboratory. I don't wanna take the River Styx just yet. It might be a long journey, a one-way journey. I don't even know. So thanks for watching. See you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.